Hi, Aries. This is your reading for the time period of August 1st to August 31st, 2020. For those of you who are new to my channel, welcome to Imani's Lightwork. All right. And if you're visiting, it's great. I hope that you decide to stay. Before I begin with your reading, I want to say, please excuse my absence from the channel. I was just busy pretty much taking care of myself, any personal matters, and refueling. All right. So I know I missed a couple of months, but I usually don't do that, especially when I first started the channel. I usually try to, be consistent with how often I upload. All right. So I'm back and I want to be able to see what you have going on for the month of August. All right. Let's see. Alright, Aries, so you have the Chariot energy underneath. The Chariot would be the sign of Cancer. It could also be travel, car travel, plane travel, whatever kind of mode of transportation that you may be looking into take, but can't do it yet. So like I was saying, I believe in Libra's reading, there's a lot going on with people and flight and travel and regulations going on with that. Wherever you reside in the United States or the world, whatever country that has, varying regulations that may not match. All right. So that's that pretty much comes into play with your plans and orchestrating. When I said coming into play with your plans, I get this idea of orchestrating. So you may have plans to orchestrate, but sooner than later too. So when I said that too, sooner than later. So if you have any plans, whatever kind of plan you have, you may want to implement them or start them, orchestrate them, whatever word you want to use. You may want to do it sooner than later. And it can never really hurt to do something sooner than later. Just make sure that at least it can be done. Okay. The starting point has the Ace of Swords energy. So the Ace of Swords would be an idea. Like I said, your ideas and travel, but who to take also. So ideas and travel, and I also get this idea of who to take. You may want to take a specific person. It's air element as well. Or it could be the Cancer, it could be a Cancerian energy underneath, but don't want to take. So when I say the Cancer, you may not want to take a Cancerian energy somewhere, but they have a good idea on where to go. I also get like where to stay. So someone could be giving you, I get this idea of reservations and things of that nature. So you could be going out of town. Like you could have managed to beat lockdown. You could have managed to find a way to travel during this time. You could have found a way to I keep getting this idea of reservations. You could have found a way to make reservations for a hotel in a different area that you may want to stay in. But I also get this idea of a Sag too. So you have Cancer underneath. You also have Sag element that's coming through, but it could be whatever fire sign, whatever water sign, but those two elements are coming through strongly because you want to, I get this idea of doing some type of reservation. I get Sag particularly doing some type of reservation with a Sagittarian energy particularly. And doing a reservation, they could be helping you. I also get packing. They could be helping you pack. They could be helping you. Packing could be packing a suitcase. Packing could be packing up your things inside of your home to move and do those kind of things. So it just depends on what's going on. If it's not anything like that, then the Chariot energy with the Ace of Swords, but want to move out of state or want to move out of town. You may want to make a residential move if it's not just like some type of vacation. I mean, the idea of, I had something about tarnish. The idea of, I mean, maybe that might not be a good word to use in terms of like a vacation, but by what's happening now, that could be your thought process with something that is going on pertaining to actually having a vacation, or you may just want to move. I mean, the idea, you know, is possible, like the possibility of moving and packing and making a residential move will be possible. I don't know too much about the vacation, but making a residential move might be possible, all right, with the help of either one of those elements there. The Nine of Cups energy is there. It doesn't have to be, like I said, it doesn't have to be residential. It could be anything. Nine of Cups energy is there. Like I said, other water sign energies could be shown up. I almost said, but that's what the Cancer does. So when I said showing off, that's what the Cancerian energy does. There's Scorpio elements, there's Pisces, but things you should save. So the water sign energy is external, things that you should save. But then there's also this element here. One of them shows off. Oh, I understand. So the Cancer underneath with the Cancerian energy underneath has everything. However you want to look at have everything. They may have a house. They may have a car. I get a family. They may have a house, a car, a family. They have the works, basically. But something's going on with them where it gets to travel. The Cancerian energy, they may get to travel. So what's happening with that is that they may be giving you, but doesn't have a right to, as I'm going on this example. They may be trying to give you their input into what you should be doing in terms of travel. I get priority. What you should be doing in terms of some type of priority. So you may want to travel. I keep getting vacation. You may want to travel for vacations and reservations and things of that nature, but their idea is to wait. And their idea also is for you to save. But Pisces think so too. So the Nine of Cups energy, Pisces, could be Scorpio too. Those water sign energies, they think so. But you're saying that the Cancerian energy particularly is showing off. Because how do they have the right? How can they tell me that I can't travel and I can, what they do? How can they tell me that I can't do what they're doing? And you may consider that to not be fair because they get to do it. You consider that to not be fair because they get to do it. They may have the same thought about you. You could be the one that's traveling all over. You may be the one that is traveling even during this pandemic. You know what I mean? And but the thought that I just gave with how you feel about them, they may also feel about, I keep getting, but they get to travel. So even if they have that thought, they still get to travel and do things that they want to do. That's why I get Scorpio too. The Scorpio gets to do that. The Pisces doesn't want to leave. The Pisces may not want to leave where they are with you, or they're somewhere else and they're trying to give you their 2 cents. Wait, they're trying to give you their 2 cents and trying to tell you to wait. I don't think it's wise for you to do this right now. I don't think it's wise for you to spend right now. I don't think it's wise for you to spend in would be the reservation. I don't think it's wise for you to do that reservation right now. Just wait. Whatever it is. But I get this idea of rush. So you may have this kind of feeling of fire up under you to rush. Why do you feel like you need a rush? That could be a question that they have. But talk amongst each other about that. So they talk amongst each other about a feeling of rush that I keep getting Sag too. It could be the Sag involved with that conversation. Or the Sag is doing something with you and the water sign energies talks amongst each other about the moves that you and the Sag make, about the moves that you want to make. And like, what's the haste? When I say that too, what is the haste? They're trying to figure out what the haste is. The present has the Ten of Swords energy. So the Ten of Swords. So that could be what I just explained just now. Could be business deal tied. It could be collaboration tied with other people. It could be workplace tied. What's the haste? Whatever it is. Or it's like, I keep getting a vacation. It heavily has to do with a vacation that you randomly want to take. You know, in the middle of the pandemic. Whatever. Whatever phase your state is in, country's in. Of this situation, what is the haste, what is the rush, you know, whatever it is. But the water sign energy doesn't want to go anyway. So the one part of it, the water sign energy, it wants to stay. The water sign energy wants to stay where they are. They're the one water sign energy. So it could be the Pisces, Then you don't understand why the Cancer, you don't understand why the Cancer gives in their two cents, but has traveled, and it could be during this time. You don't understand why the Cancer is giving their two cents, because they may have traveled during this time. The Pisces, whichever one of the water signs, that could resonate with the Cancer or it doesn't. That may resonate with the Pisces. The Pisces want to stay, but also want to leave. They also want to leave, but they may, I get to save. They also want to leave, but they may prefer to stay a little longer so that they can save. You know, but the Ten of Swords energy is in the present choices. The Ten of Swords energy in the present is, has something to do with your choices, someone's choices. It's also air sign, like I said from before. So Aquarian, Libra, Gemini energy, but the invitation. So the Aquarian, Libra, Gemini, whichever one of the air sign, they may be the ones that are trying to give you some type of invitation. But I get to travel far. They could be coming in with an invitation to get you to travel somewhere far with them. That's why the Ace of Swords energy is there, but can't. The Ace of Swords is there, Ten of Swords. You're telling the air sign element, I get an Aquarian. You're telling an Aquarian, I can't. You can be telling Gemini or Libra, whatever air sign, you're telling them you can't. I get yet. You're telling you can't yet. You know? But disappointed. So the air sign elements may be disappointed. They could be disappointed, but going to go anyway. So I'm looking at the Nine of Cups energy. You may, Ten of Swords with the Nine of Cups, you're going to go anyway. You're going to go anyway. And the Pisces element, disgusted. One of the Pisces element may be disgusted. They may be annoyed. Water sign energy may be disgusted. They're annoyed. But don't understand why you can't wait. So when I ran through all of them, they don't understand why you can't wait. They don't understand why you can't wait. Whatever it is that is happening here as well. You know, with the Ten of Swords energy being in the present. You know what I mean? They think that you, Ten of Swords, they think you should save money. They think you should save money. They also think you should wait for them. And that could be the same thought that you have with the air sign, but telling them something. It's the air sign element that I feel is calling you or inviting you to do something with them. And it changing mind also. They could be changing their mind, or you're changing your mind and making the water sign happy. So the choice has to do with making the water sign energy happy. Making them happy. The future has the Three of Cups energy. So the Three of Cups energy is in the future. That would be gossip of any kind. That could be gossip. That could be the gossip that the water keep talking about. That's gossip. The water sign energies keep talking about something. They keep talking about where your money goes. They talk about where your money goes, what you're putting your money into, but who you're giving it to, who you're giving your money to, where it goes. Three of Cups energy in the future. That's what the water sign energy is. But I also get with the air sign. The water sign energies talk about that with the air sign element. That's why the Ten of Swords is in the present. They talk about where the money, the air signs and the water sign energies. That's why the Ten of Swords, and I understand, the Ten of Swords energy is there. I get my partner. You're like, my partner is conversing. I also get an ex. Your partner could be, your partner could have gotten in a situation where they're having a conversation with your ex. Or your new partner, or your family member. I also get aunt. Your ex could be your ex, or your partner could be talking to your aunt, some family member that you have, spending habit. They're talking about your spending habit that you have. That's why the Ten of Swords, but gave the invitation. So it's kind of, I understand, it's contradictory for the air sign voice their opinion. It's the air sign element could be contradicting themselves by voicing an opinion that they have about your spending habits. But at the same time, they're taking the side of the water sign. But doesn't make sense. So Ten of Swords, that doesn't make any sense for the air sign element to do. But don't realize too. So the Nine of Cups, the water sign energy may not realize that about the water sign interaction. The water sign energies don't interact. Okay, I almost said don't interact. Something could be going on there with not interacting with someone. But the water sign energies, they do not, they don't realize that their partner, they don't realize, one of them could be a partner, yes, but they don't realize, I get ex, they don't realize that they're interacting with your ex or a shared something secretive. They don't realize that they shared something secretive with an ex that you have or a partner that you have. So cups will be family. So your family members could have talked to your partner about your spending habits. Your family members could have spoken to your partner about your spending habits. But it's like your partner is giving the invitation, but it's at the same time contradict. Okay, your partner is giving an invitation for you to do something with them, and but at the same time they're talking with your why you shouldn't do it. They're talking with your family members and friends into why you shouldn't do it, but they're the ones that give the invitation. So if they didn't give the invitation, you probably You probably would have overlooked it if they didn't come in to even give you the invitation in the first place. You know what I mean? You could be doing that to someone as well, too. I was in the Sag and things of that nature with the Ten of Swords energy as well. You could be doing that. Sag, air sign elements is giving invitation. They're the ones that are giving you the invitation. The water sign, I get confused. The water sign energies are confused because they may be finding out what's really going on. The water sign energies could be finding out what's really going on with the Sag and the air sign. I get coming in out of nowhere with the Sag. And one of the air sign elements coming in out of nowhere with a random invitation. Some type of invitation. But I get something about either something isn't good. Something is either good or not good about the reason. I get sneaky. Something may be sneaky about one of the water sign energies. Something may be sneaky about them. Or something is sneaky air sign. Something may be sneaky about one of the air signs or the Sag. But proposition. So something sneaky about them because of a proposition that they have. Some type of proposition that they're coming in with. And that's why don't indulge. The water sign energy is trying to tell you don't indulge in the air sign, one of the air sign elements or the Sag element. But Sag, okay. So when I say that the Sag is okay, but they don't think you should indulge with the air sign element for some reason. I get risk. As I'm talking about the air sign, I get risk. You could maybe risking something that you have that is important. That's why the Ten of Swords is heavy energy. It would be considered heavy energy, but it doesn't have to be. But you would be risking something serious by interacting or dealing with or doing some type of, and you know, taking up a proposition by that the air sign element is coming in to give you. But something's going on here. I'm looking at the water sign, but I saw they could have seen something that the air sign. I get with Sag. They saw or they heard about something that it's some type of involvement that the air sign element has with the Sag. You know little about. And the water sign energies want to give you the whole story. The water sign energies may want to give you the whole story. The whole story. But it's bringing me back to invitation. So. It's bringing me back to the idea of an invitation. So if the Sag, the reason, if the Sag or the air sign element is coming in with an invitation, be leery of the reason into why they're coming in with this, some type of invitation. Be leery of the invitation. That's why the Nine of Cups energy, but you need to talk to the water sign and what they saw and heard. You need to talk to the water sign energy about what they saw and heard. But I get this idea of a post office and things, but watches Sag. So when I say post office and things of that nature, they watch a Sag element. They may watch an air sign, you know, they may watch an air, just heard something about, they heard something about an air sign, but they watch or they keep their eyes on a Sag. And that could be something there could be what they're relating to you that they, but don't believe. So Ten of Swords, you don't believe what the water sign energies are trying to tell you about a Sag or an air sign. You don't believe what they're telling you. What did you see in here? But what is he doing? What did you see in here? What did you see him doing? And the him could be air sign male, could be Sag, could be male. Whatever. Interesting. And that could be, that's either happening to you direct, also happens to water sign. That could be something that's happening to you directly, those kind of situations, communications, or that's something that you observe, happens to the water sign all the time. That happens to the water sign energy all the time. So that's why I said what you're talking about, the water sign gets to do this, that, and the third. But it's like their partner cheats. When I said that, their partner cheats. One of the water sign energies partner, they cheat. And the seeing the Sag something could be their partner. The seeing the air sign element do something, their friend. The seeing the air sign element do something, say something, do something strange, is the one of the water sign energies, their friend. It's their affiliate. Something really interesting there. But one something is also going on here with the Sag. One element about this is the Sag communicating with Aquarian. The Sag communicating with the Aquarian. But that's what they saw. So I'm looking at the Nine of Cups energy. That's what the water sign energy saw. They saw a Sag interacting with an Aquarian somewhere. whatever. They saw them do something, say something. They saw them doing, having some type of conversation, whatever it is. The Ten of Pentacles energy is, and the Aquarian, like I said, could be male, female Aquarian. Or, like, Sag could be male, female Sag. But the spirit also say, I saw him do something. Could be Sag male. Could be an Aquarian male. Conversation together. Whatever. Male, female. It could be Sag, female, Aquarian, male. It could be Aquarian, female, Sag, male. Whatever. Ten of Pentacles energy is an instinct there. Okay? So, the Ten of Pentacles would be money. You know? But financial situation. So, what's happening there with people relating things and seeing things and hearing conversations. It's some part of it is, it is a financial situation. You know, it is a financial situation. That's why Nine of Cups is there with water sign and not using money. But on someone's going, you're not using money on the air sign, not using money on them. That could be something that you want to tell the water sign, but not to give Sag. You're telling the water sign energy not to give something to the Sag element. You're telling you may want to tell them that. Not to give something to the water. Okay, you're telling the water sign not to give something to the Sag that they already have. Not to give something to the Sag. The Sag already has, or the Sag was already given something. Whatever it is. But a Ten of Pentacles, that's why I said it's a money situation. It's a money, a deal. It's a money deal. Some element about it is a money deal. Ten of Swords energy, it is a money deal. You know? So it could be a money deal intertwined with a vacation. Whatever it is, you know, it could be a money deal, but to get you to spend. So when I said a money deal intertwined with a vacation, an invitation, is to get you to spend. So the Ten of Swords, and it's to get you to spend money on someone. It's to get you just spend. It's to get you to just spend, either spend time with someone or just spend money. That's why the Ten of Pentacles is an instinct. It's to get you to spend. It's to get someone to just spend money. It's to get someone to spend. You know, whatever it is, just to get someone to spend, whatever, spend time, spend money. The Four of Swords energy is next to, is in the accomplishment right next to the Ace of Swords energy. I don't know. I look at the Four of Swords, but they trying to call you and whatever. The Four of Swords energy is there in the accomplishment. You know, I don't know. You could be telling the air sign element, I'm not sure. You're telling the air sign, I'm not sure if I want to do this. Whatever, I'm not sure if I want to take this walk with you and talk about this. I'm not sure if I want to take you up on this kind of proposition. And I also get a deposit. I'm not sure if I want to make a deposit. Whatever it is, I'm not sure if I want you to deposit your money into my account. I'm just making up situations. You know, whatever it is. But the idea, what I was receiving was, I'm not sure. But your conversations with someone, I also get legit too. Conversations with someone imply that something is legit that someone wants to do with you. Something is legit about it, but leery. Something is legit, but there's an energy attached to it that may also imply that you may be leery, air sign. You may be leery of the air sign. Water sign energies may, Sag. Water sign energies may be leery of the Sag. Or something that they're doing. I don't know. Or something that they want to do. I took. Something that they took. Or they saw them take. Could be pills. I don't know. It could be medication. That kind of stuff. Or they whatever. Saw them take. They saw them. Something that they saw them take from somewhere. Take something from someone. That could be why. That could be why someone doesn't want you to go spend time or hang out with someone. Because of that. You know. Integrity may be intertwined with that too. Something going on with your integrity or theirs or the air sign or the Sag or whoever. Somebody's integrity, you know? That's why the Four of Swords is really, the Four of Swords energy is in the accomplishment because it's like you, I get deserve too. You may deserve something. You may deserve it. You may deserve, what's the situation? You may deserve a reservation somewhere or someone else may deserve it, something like that. You may deserve some type of reservation of some type. Hotel reservation, whatever it is. Some type of reservation. You know? Whatever. Restaurant reservation. You may deserve something like that. Someone may not think so. They do or they do not. Or whatever. But who you want to go with or who you're talking about that you want to do it with, That could be where someone, you may not be reading, you may not be reading through an invitation, but other family members and friends may be reading through someone for you, or their motive, something like that. Interesting. The King of Cups energy is in the spiritual self right next to the Nine of Cups. So, King of Cups energy, Pisces, Cancer, Scorpio, that's a male. I was getting an idea of a Pisces. Could be Pisces male, Cancerian energy, that's a male. The Nine of Cups brings in all elements, all female and male elements. But the King of Cups energy is there. But thinks you deserve. So, they think you do deserve. It could be something that they want to do with you. That the air sign, I forbid. It's something that they want to do with you that the air sign element forbids. Whatever. It could be something that they want to do that the air sign element may not want you to do with them for some reason. Or it's something that the air sign wants to do with you that they forbid. You do. That's why I said spending and saving. Think you should save. I don't think you... I give you a perfect scenario of this. This is like getting an invitation from a friend to go stay in a hotel in Atlantic City. As simple as that. And they're like, I don't think you should go. You know, I think you should save what you have. Don't spend it yet. You know, wait. That's why I was getting that idea of waiting. Wait a little bit. Or they are your partner, and one element, if you're not going with someone, they're with you, and they're with you, but they have like a differing view of something that you want to do. So like I said, propositions and invitations and reservations, they just have a differing view than you. The mentality has the Six of Swords energy there. So the Six of Swords is still air sign. It's also this idea of being really certain. But where money is coming from. Being really certain into where money is coming from. Or who's giving you money. It's air sign element. You know? Like the idea of being really certain. A clean source. Being really certain also implies that you're trying to explain to someone that the money is coming from a clean source or a person or something's going on with the person that you're getting the money from or that's giving you the coming in with the proposition. Someone that may be giving you a proposition to do something. Something may not be right with someone. You know what I mean? Like something may not be right with them, like mentally. There's a lot of swords here as well too. Something may not be right with someone mentally as well that you are interacting with. But read the fine print. So when I said that too, when I said interacting with someone that may not be mentally well, the spirit said read the fine print with the air sign. But that's what they said. So when I said I'm looking at the King of Cups energy, that's what they said or that's what they observe. Something strange. Whatever it is, that Six of Swords in the mentality. Reading the fine print with a reservation that someone's coming out of nowhere with. Whatever it is. So the idea of somebody coming in with an invitation to do something and then they turn around and say you shouldn't do it is something is mentally, something isn't right that's mentally going on there with somebody too. So how could someone come in and say, yeah, let's go do this, that, and the third? And I had switch. So they're coming in and they're like, someone could be bipolar. That sounds like bipolar to me. Someone could be coming in and they're like, let's go do this, that, and the third. Let's get this reservation to go do this, that, and the third. I keep getting, and then they switch, and then they switch. And that's confusing. So when I say that too, you're like, that's confusing. That behavior, it's strange. That behavior is strange. that behavior is confusing. I don't understand. The movement, I don't understand his movement, his or her movement. Whatever it is, it's strange to me. And that could be but that's what they said. That's what the King of Cups energy said. You know, that's what they said. That's what you said to them. That's what they said. They could be telling you, use your intuition. Whatever it is. Something's interesting there. What's changing is the Two of Wands energy. So, Two of Wands energy would be patience. Maybe you don't need to have patience with it. I get made a choice. You don't need to be patient with something anymore, the Two of Wands is like waiting too. So you don't need to wait anymore because you've made a choice or you're making a choice. Are you trying to make one? King of Cups could be trying to help you, I get, decide. They're trying to help you decide what to do about something. I get someone you're getting introduced to. They're trying to help you decide on what to do about who's getting introduced to you, or somebody that's being introduced to you, or someone that they could be setting up someone that they may have someone that they want to introduce to you for business. But is it mentally, sometimes when I said that too, someone that the King of Cups energy wants to introduce you to in terms of business, that person, something isn't mentally, something is unstable about that business partner that someone does want to introduce to you to work with. But someone may not realize that, you know what I mean? And that could be why from early on in the reading, they changed their mind. They changed, the King of Cups energy changed their mind about letting you go somewhere, about working with someone, about taking up an invitation, whatever. So at one point, the King of Cups energy, go. The King of Cups energy could have been like, go. But then they saw or heard something strange from other water signs, or they could have sent someone to go watch someone, go listen to a conversation. They could have done that, or they want to do that. And they're like, they may not want to tell you the detail, what they saw. They may not want to tell you details into something that they saw or heard. So they're trying to get you to change your mind really quickly. They're trying to get you to change your mind really quickly so that you won't, what's the situation? So that you won't go and leave with them. You know what I mean? Because in the beginning, they thought someone was okay. In the beginning, they thought someone that you're dealing with was okay. But they saw something or they heard something. And I keep getting this idea of a switch. Somebody could have switched off. like a bipolar episode. Someone could have switched off in mid-conversation with them. But scared them. So when I said that, it scared the King of Cups energy. It scared them. Wow. Something's creepy about it too. The Seven of Pentacles is in the resolution going towards the Three of Cups energy. So Seven of Pentacles would be, I had a bonus. The Seven of Pentacles, something that could be going on here work-related. It's work-related because of propositions and money and whatever. But the Seven of Pentacles, but how to make, Seven of Pentacles is how to make money too. How to make money. You know, after someone that was referred to work with you, I keep getting, is it something is going on? Every time I say that, something is unstable about an air sign element that you are being hooked up to work with. Something's just unstable. You know what I mean? Something is unstable about somebody. Something's unstable. But the Seven of Pentacles in the resolution is how to make money without that person. That's why the Four of Swords is there. Well, the Ace of Swords, because you could be trying to do research. Someone that was sent to you. You're trying to do research on someone that was sent to work with you. That's why I said somebody's referral to work with you. Something isn't right with that person. So you're trying to do research into what is going on. Something that could be is neurologically going on with someone that is being hooked up to work with you. Whatever it is. And the water sign energy is like, they scared me. So I think you should not go anywhere with them. Like an episode. Like somebody may have bipolar episodes that they don't realize. Someone has bipolar episodes that they go on bipolar episodes that they're not realizing that they're going on bipolar episodes. As simple as that. The Seven of Pentacles with the Three of Cups energy there. You know, and the water sign energies, I also get this idea of laughing too. The water sign energies could be laughing. Something maybe, I mean, nothing is really funny about, but I get this idea of smoking too much too. Someone probably smokes too much that you are working. They do something, some type of drug, or they do something too much, and something could be causing some type of chemical problem there. You know, And that could be some of the water sign energy talks about with King of Cups and Scorpio or Pisces males and whatever. They talk about that, or they laugh. Somebody laughs about something. I mean, it's not right, but someone may laugh about something there too. If somebody hooks up someone to work with you and they don't realize, okay, the person that's being hooked up to work with you or interact with you doesn't realize they're ill. They don't realize that they're ill. So it's like, if someone doesn't realize that they're ill, then that could be where, okay, if someone doesn't realize that they are ill, that could, I get for a business, if someone doesn't realize that they are ill, then that could cause problems within a business. That could cause a, something strange to happen within a business, or cause, even, it's somebody, one person's illness could cause other people, I get to not work well. One person's illness could cause other people somewhere to not work well. Something interesting like that. But it's mental health tied. So it's like, you know, it's that something needs to happen there. You know, which is interesting. All right. Let's see. So it's like a boss, you know what I mean? The Six of Swords energy came out again. It's like somebody that's being hired to be a boss may have bipolar disorder. So someone that is hired to be, is a boss somewhere, or the head of a business deal, has, is bipolar. But it's causing problems with other people. But the Six of Swords energy is there. Let me do another outcome. Wow. And the World energy is here. So there's a leaving workplace. You may want to leave a workplace with the World energy there. You may want to leave a workplace, depart from a workplace. This could be happening in a workplace and someone is trying to tell you, you know, don't take an invitation from, if it, you know, a boss could be giving you an invitation. A coworker could be giving you an invitation. Your partner is like, I don't think you should go with them because they got bipolar stuff going on. Whatever it is, as simple as that too. I don't think you should take up an invitation from them. But someone may be sporadic, you know? And something scary about it, too. So they got scared. The King of Cups energy got scared of the... It's something scary about the air sign elements. Something's going on there with the, mentally with the air sign. But the air sign doesn't see that. One air sign element does not see that something's going on with them. And it's something scary that the King of Cups energy observe. So I'll give you a perfect example. This is like somebody being a drinker. I'll give you a perfect example. Somebody being a drink, their behavior. Somebody being a drinker, and their behavior is they don't realize that I don't remember. They don't remember what they did or said the previous day or hour. And that's what's scary. When I say that too, I get that's what's scary. That's why the Six of Swords is there with the World. That's what's scary. You know what I mean? That's what's scary. All right then. Well, there it is, Aries. Let me know how it resonates. Be well. Take care. Bye.